Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaliyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the solution and discussion on gate question papers in mechanical engineering. And this is lecture number 34 on the discussion on gate question paper. The topic for this lecture is conduction heat transfer. So we solved few problems in the conduction heat transfer from various gate question papers. The first question is from 1988 question paper. Steam is flowing through an insulated steel pipe as shown in the figure, losing heat to the surroundings. The details are as follows. Inner radius of the steel pipe R1 equal to 50 mm. Outer radius of the steel pipe R2 equal to 57 mm. Outer radius of the insulation R3 equal to 157 mm. Thermal conductivity of the steel K1 equal to 43 watts per meter Kelvin. Thermal conductivity of the insulation 0.1 watts per meter Kelvin. Heat transfer coefficient on the steam side, inside heat transfer coefficient 570 watts per meter square Kelvin. Heat transfer coefficient on the air side, outside heat transfer coefficient HO equal to 12 watts per meter square Kelvin. Temperature of the steam TI equal to 500 degrees Celsius. Temperature of the surrounding TO equal to 30 degrees Celsius. Calculate the heat loss per meter length of the pipe and temperature of the outer surface of the insulation. So this is the configuration. Inside the pipe steam is flowing. Outside we have the air convection through the air. We write down the given data. All the data R1, R2, R3, K1, K2, HI, HO, TI, TO, everything is written here. Now this is the arrangement. So we have inside steam is flowing, we have the steel insulation, and then we have the air convection on the air, and we have to calculate the resistances. So the inside convection resistance Ri equal to 1 by 2 pi R1 into L into HI. R1 is the inner radius of the steel pipe, HI is the inside heat transfer coefficient of the steam side. So substituting 2 pi into 0.05 into length equal to 1 meter into 570 equal to 5.58 10 power minus 3 Kelvin per watt. R1, the resistance due to the steel, 1 by 2 pi K1 into L into logarithmic of R2 by R1, which is 1 by 2 pi into K1 equal to 43, and the length of the pipe equal to 1. So logarithmic of 0.057 divided by 0.05 equal to 4.852 into 10 power minus 4 Kelvin per watt. R2, the resistance due to the insulation, 1 by 2 pi K2 into L, so into logarithmic of R3 by R2, substituting numerical values, 1 by 2 pi into K2 equal to 0.1 watts per meter Kelvin, and length equal to 1 meter into logarithmic of 0.157 divided by 0.057 equal to 1.613 Kelvin per watt. And the outside convection resistance RO equal to 1 by 2 pi R3 into L into HO. So substituting all the numerical values, HO equal to 12. So 1 by 2 pi into 0.157 into 1 into 12 equal to 0.0845 Kelvin per watt. Now the heat transfer. So heat transfer equal to temperature difference, inside temperature difference minus outside temperature difference divided by sum of all the resistances. So 500 minus 30, substituting all the resistance values, the heat transfer is 275.89 watts. Then the temperature on the outer surface, so we take the last resistance Q equal to T3 minus TO divided by RO. So 275.89 equal to T3 minus 30 divided by 0.0845. So calculating T3 equal to 53.31 degrees Celsius. So the heat transfer is 275.89 watts, and the temperature of the insulation, outer surface of the insulation, is 53.31 degree Celsius. So these are all the two answers. Next question from 1993 question paper. An electrical hot plate is maintained at a temperature of 350 degree Celsius and is used to keep the solution boiling at 95 degree Celsius. The solution is contained in cast iron vessel of wall thickness 25 mm, which is enameled inside to a thickness of 0.8 millimeter. The heat transfer coefficient for the boiling solution is 5.5 kilowatts per meter square Kelvin, and the thermal conductivities of cast iron and the enamel are 50 and 1.05 watts per meter Kelvin respectively. Calculate overall heat transfer coefficient. So OHTC is overall heat transfer coefficient and rate of heat transfer per unit area. So this is the arrangement. So we have the cast iron vessel and the enamel coating, and then we have the solution which is boiling. And the given data, T1 equal to 350 degrees Celsius, TO equal to 95 degrees Celsius, L1 is 0.025 meter, L2 is 0.8 into 10 power minus 3 meter, HO equal to 5.5 kilowatts per meter square Kelvin, K1 equal to 50 kilowatts per meter Kelvin, and K2 equal to 1.05 watts per meter Kelvin. Now, calculating the resistances. Resistance due to the cast iron vessel. So, L1 by A into K1. So, we take area equal to 1 meter square, 0.025 divided by 1 into 50 equal to 0.005 degrees Celsius per watts. And R2 is the resistance due to the enamel coating. So, L2 by A into K2, 0.0008 divided by 1 into 1.05 equal to 0.000762 degrees Celsius per watt. RO is the resistance, convection resistance, 1 by A into HO. So, it is given as 5.5 kilowatts per meter square Kelvin. So, this is 1 by 1 into 5500, which is 0.00182 degrees Celsius per watt. Now, we calculate the overall heat transfer coefficient. First, we calculate the total resistance. Sum of all the resistances R1 plus R2 plus R3 equal to 1.444 into 10 power minus 3 Kelvin per watt. So, RA multiplying by area equal to 1 meter square. So, RA equal to 1.444 in 10 power minus 3 meter square Kelvin per watts. And U, overall heat transfer coefficient, you remember this equation, overall heat transfer coefficient equal to 1 by RA. So, 1 by RA equal to 1 by 1.444 into 10 power minus 3 equal to 692.5 watts per meter square Kelvin. Then we calculate the rate of heat transfer. Rate of heat transfer is the temperature difference divided by the total resistance. So, T1 minus TO divided by total resistance, 350 minus 95 divided by 1.444 in 10 power minus 3 equal to 176.7 kilowatts per meter square. So, this is the overall heat transfer coefficient and the overall heat transfer coefficient 692.5 watts per meter square Kelvin, and the rate of heat transfer is 176.7 kilowatts per meter square. The next question from 1998 question paper, a gas filled tube has 2 mm inside diameter and 25 cm long, gas filled tube. The gas is heated by an electrical wire of diameter 50 microns located along the axis of the tube. The current and the voltage drop across the heating element is 0.5 ampere and 4 volt respectively. It is measured the wire and the inside tube wall temperatures are 175 degrees Celsius and the 150 degree Celsius respectively. Find the thermal conductivity of the gas filling the tube. So, the data given, radius of the wire, outer radius of the wire 25 micron, which is 0.025 millimeter. Inner radius of the tube R2 equal to 1 millimeter, length equal to 25 centimeter 0.25 meter, T1 equal to 175 degree Celsius, T2 equal to 150 degree Celsius, and the voltage equal to 4 volt and ampere equal to 0.5 ampere. Now, thermal conductivity of the gas filling the tube. So, we have to calculate Q equal to V into I. So, amount of heat transfer equal to voltage into current flow into 2 pi KL into T1 minus T2 divided by logarithmic of R2 by R1. So, this is cylindrical system. So, now we have to calculate thermal conductivity of the gas which is inside the tube. So, K equal to cross multiplying VI into logarithmic of R2 by R1. Divided by 2 pi L into T1 minus T2. Substituting all the numerical values, 0.5 into 4 into logarithmic of 1 divided by 0.025. 1 millimeter divided by 0.025 millimeter. Substitute in millimeter, 2 pi into 0.25 into 175 minus 150. So, this is equal to 0.188 watts per meter Kelvin. So, the thermal conductivity of the gas is 0.188 watts per meter Kelvin. The next question from 2001 question paper, a composite wall having unit length normal to the plane of paper is insulated at the top and bottom as shown in the figure. So, this is the diagram. It is comprised of 4 different material A, B, C, D. dimensions are HA equal to HD equal to 3 centimeter. So height HA equal to HD equal to 3 centimeter, HB equal to HC equal to 1.5 centimeter. The thickness L1 equal to L3 equal to 0.05 meter and L2 equal to 0.2 meter. Thermal conductivity of the material KA equal to KD equal to 50 watts per meter Kelvin, KB equal to 10 watts per meter Kelvin and KC equal to 1 watts per meter Kelvin. The fluid temperature and the heat transfer coefficient are T1 equal to 200 degrees Celsius, H1 equal to 50 watts per meter square Kelvin and T2 equal to 25 degrees Celsius, H2 equal to 10 watts per meter square Kelvin. Assuming one dimensional heat transfer condition, determine rate of heat transfer through the wall. So this is the composite wall with the parallel resistances. So we have to calculate all the resistances, then the equivalent resistance, then we have to calculate the heat transfer, rate of heat transfer. So we reproduce the drawing once again. All the data are reproduced here. So HA equal to HD equal to 3 cm, HB equal to HC equal to 1.5 cm, length L1 equal to L2, L3 equal to 0.05 meter, L2 equal to 0.2 meter, and the thermal conductivity, temperature, heat transfer coefficient, everything is reproduced. Now we have to draw the thermal circuit for the composite wall arrangement. So this is the thermal circuit. So R1 is the inside heat transfer coefficient, RA is the resistance due to the slab A, RB is the resistance due to the slab B and RC is the resistance due to the slab C, RD is the resistance due to the slab material D, R2 is the outside heat transfer coefficient, T1, T2 are the temperatures what is given, 225 degree Celsius. Now we have to calculate all the resistances. So one by one, first we take calculate the convection resistance, R1 equal to 1 by A into HI. So area we have to calculate. So area, depth equal to 1 meter. So this height equal to 0.3 centimeter, 0.03 meter. And depth perpendicular to the screen is 1 meter. So the area equal to 1 into 0.03. So 1 is the width of the plate perpendicular to the screen. And 0.03 is the height of the slab into 50 is the heat transfer coefficient, heat transfer coefficient inside 50 watts per meter square Kelvin. So it is 0.67 Kelvin per watt. R2, similarly outside heat transfer coefficient, outside convection resistance, R2 equal to 1 by A into H2. Similarly, the area equal to 1 into 0.03 into 10 equal to 3.33 Kelvin per watt. And the conduction resistances, RA equal to L1 by AA into KA. So 0.05 into 1 into 0.03 into 50. 50 is the thermal conductivity of the material A. So 0.033 Kelvin per watt. RB equal to L2 by AB into KB. So 0.1 divided by 1 into 0.015 into 10 equal to 0.667 Kelvin per watt. RC equal to L2 by AC into KC, so 0.1 divided by 1 into 0.015 into 1 equal to 6.67 Kelvin per watt. Now, the RB and the RC, they are parallel resistances. So, we have to calculate the equivalent resistance RBC, so which is RB into RC divided by RB plus RC. So, 0.667 into 6.67 divided by 0.667 plus 6.67 equal to 0.606 Kelvin per watt. And the RD, the resistance due to the slab D, L3 by AD into KD, which is 0.05 into 1 into 0.03 into 50 equal to 0.033 Kelvin per watt. Now, the total resistance, R equivalent equal to R1 plus RA plus RBC plus RD plus R2. So, substituting all the values, the total resistance equal to 4.6726 Kelvin per watt. And we calculate the rate of heat transfer. So T1 minus T2 divided by equivalent resistance, 200 minus 25 divided by 4.6726 equal to 37.45 watts. So this is the amount of heat transfer, the answer to the question. The next question, a copper tube of 20 mm diameter and 1 mm thickness and 20 meter long of thermal conductivity 400 watts per meter Kelvin is carrying saturated steam at 150 degrees Celsius with a convective heat transfer coefficient 150 watts per meter square Kelvin. The tube is exposed to ambient air at 27 degrees Celsius with the convective heat transfer coefficient is 5 watts per meter square Kelvin. Glass wool is used for insulation of thermal conductivity 0.075 watts per meter Kelvin. If the thickness of the insulation is 5 millimeter higher than the critical thickness of insulation, calculate the rate of heat loss by the steam and rate of steam condensation in kilograms per hour. The enthalpy of condensation is 2230 kilojoules per kilogram. So, we have written all the data given here. So, RO is 0.01 meter, RI equal to 0.009 meter, KC equal to KC. KC means thermal conductivity of the copper material, tube material, 400 watts per meter Kelvin, HI equal to 150 watts per meter square Kelvin, TI equal to 150 degrees Celsius, TO equal to 27 degrees Celsius, HO equal to 5 watts per meter square Kelvin, thermal conductivity of glass wool equal to 0.075 watts per meter Kelvin, and the outer radius of the glass wool insulation equal to critical radius plus 5 millimeter. So, HFG equal to 2230 kilojoules per kilogram and length of the tube is 20 meter. Now, this is the arrangement. So, the steam, first we have inside heat transfer, inside flow steam, and we have the copper tube, glass wool insulation, and then we have the air on the outside. The critical radius of the insulation. So, RC equal to KG by HO, which is 0.075 divided by 5 equal to 0.015 meter. RG equal to 0.015 plus 0.005 equal to 0.02 meter. So, the outer radius of the glass wool insulation is 0.02 meter. Now, we calculate the thermal resistances. All the thermal resistances, RI, 1 by 2 pi RI L into HI, substituting all the numerical values, 2 pi into 0.009 into length equal to 20 meter into 150 equal to 0.0059 Kelvin per watt. Resistance to the copper material 1 by 2 pi KC into L into logarithmic of RO by RI, which is 1 by 2 pi KC equal to 400 into 20 into logarithmic of 0.01 divided by 0.009 equal to 2.1 in 10 power minus 6 Kelvin per watt. Resistance due to the glass wool material 1 by 2 pi kg into L into logarithmic of Rg by RO, which is 1 divided by 2 pi into 0.075 into 20 into logarithmic of 0.02 divided by 0.01 equal to 0.0736 Kelvin per watt. RO, outside convection resistance by the air, 1 by 2 pi Rg into L into HO. So, substituting 1 by 2 pi 0.02 into 20 into 5 equal to 0.0796 Kelvin per watt. The total resistance, adding all the values, substituting all the values and calculating the total, it is 0.159 Kelvin per watt. Then the rate of heat transfer Q equal to TI minus TO divided by the total resistance, which is 150 minus 27 divided by 0.159773, which is 773.58 watts. So, the amount of heat transfer equal to 773.58 watts. Then we have to calculate the rate of condensation of the steam. So, the amount of heat transferred to the steam, that is equal to M into HFG. So, M is the mass of the steam condensed and HFG is the latent heat of condensation. So, 773.58 equal to M into 2230 into 1000. So, the 1000 is to convert the kilojoules per kilogram into joules per kilogram. So, calculating M equal to 3.47 10 power minus 4 kilograms per second, or 1.249 kilograms per hour. So, we have to calculate the answer. The question is, we have to calculate the heat transfer 773.58 watt and the amount of condensation in kilograms per hour 1.249 kilograms per hour. So, these are all the answers to the question. The next question on the unsteady state heat transfer. The heat transfer process between a body and its ambient is governed by internal conductive resistance ICR and the external convective resistance ECR. The body can be considered to be lumped heat capacity system if ICR is greater than ECR, ICR is marginally smaller than ECR, ECR equal to ICR, ICR is negligible small. So, the lumped parameter system or lumped capacity system is applicable only when the conduction resistance is negligible. Internal conduction resistance is negligible. The answer is ICR is negligible. Next question, 1991. So, Biot number signifies ratio of heat conducted to the heat convected, ratio of heat convected to the heat conducted, the ratio of external convective resistance to the internal conductive resistance. ratio of internal conductive resistance to the external convective resistance. So we define the Biot number. Biot number equal to resistance to the conduction to the divided by resistance to the convection. So LC by KA divided by 1 by HA. So simplifying HLC by K. That is the definition. That is the equation for Biot number. So the Biot number is the ratio of resistance to the conduction to the divided by resistance to the convection. So the answer is D. Ratio of internal conductive resistance to the external convective resistance. So the lumped parameter method is applicable, or the Biot number, when the Biot number is very low, we can apply the lumped parameter method. So for that, the conduction resistance, the K value should be infinite. That is the condition. Biot number should be minimum for applying the lumped parameter system, where the thermal conductivity is very high for the material. When the fluid velocity is doubled, the thermal time constant of a thermometer used for measuring the fluid temperature reduces by the factor of 2. Whether this is true or false? The statement is false. We will prove. The thermal time constant of the thermocouple, tau equal to rho Vc divided by H into As. So rho Vc, they are constant. We calculate only the, we have to measure the effect of the velocity. So the thermal time constant is a is proportional to 1 by H. H is the heat transfer coefficient. And the heat transfer coefficient is from the Nusselt number. So Nusselt number in any heat transfer calculation, Nusselt number is a function of Reynolds number and Prandtl number. So Reynolds number, again, it involves the velocity. Prandtl number is the, there is no velocity term. Reynolds number is Reynolds number is velocity into diameter divided by the kinematic viscosity. So velocity is there in the numerator. So for the heat transfer calculation, heat transfer coefficient is proportional to the Reynolds number to the power 0.5, that is the velocity to the power 0.5. So the, now taking the proportion relationship, H is proportional to V to the power 0.5, substitute here in the time constant term. So time constant is a proportional to 1 by velocity to the power 0.5. Now we use the equation for two limit, 1 and 2. So initial and the final value. So tau 2 divided by tau 1 equal to v1 by v2 to the power 0.5. So v1 by 2 v1 to the power 0.5. That is what velocity is doubled. So final velocity is equal to 2 times of initial velocity. So 1 by 2 to the power 0.5 equal to 0.7. So the final time constant equal to 0.7 times of initial time constant. So it is only varying by approximately 0.7. So the by reduces by the factor 2 is not correct. That is why the statement is false. The next question from 2001 question paper. Lumped heat transfer analysis of a solid object suddenly exposed to a fluid medium at a different temperature is valid when Biot number is less than 0.1. Biot number greater than 0.1, Fourier number less than 0.1, Fourier number less greater than 0.1. So the Biot number should be less than 0.1 for applying lumped parameter method. So for Biot number less than 0.1, the thermal conductivity of the material should be high. Then only the resistance to the conduction will be negligible. So, for applying the by a lumped parameter method, the main condition is the resistance to the conduction is negligible. So, when the resistance to the conduction is negligible, thermal conductivity should be very high for the material. So, the HLC by K, when K is very high, Biot number will be very less. So, normally, when the Biot number is less than 0.1, we will apply the lumped parameter method. The value of Biot number is very small, less than 0.1, when the convective resistance to the fluid is negligible. When the conductive resistance to the fluid is negligible. When the conductive resistance to the solid is negligible. None of the above. So, it is obvious. Option C, the conductive resistance of the solid is negligible. When it is negligible, then the Biot number will be less than 0.1. Which one of the following configuration has the highest fin effectiveness? Thin, closely spaced, thin, widely spaced, thick, widely spaced, thick, closely spaced. So, thin, fin, closely spaced. That is the correct answer. Thin, fin, closely spaced. The effectiveness should be greater than 2. So, for any fin configuration, fin arrangement, we have to calculate the effectiveness. Effectiveness should be greater than 2. So, we we can achieve higher effectiveness by the following parameter: selecting the material of higher thermal conductivity, increasing perimeter by area ratio. That is what perimeter by area ratio is, the thin and closely spaced. Use the fin where H value is smaller. That is also another condition to achieve higher effectiveness of the fin. But from the given parameter, given point, so thin and closely spaced fin is the correct answer. Next question from 2014 question paper. Biot number signifies the ratio of convective resistance to the fluid to the conductive resistance of the solid. Conductive resistance in the solid to the convective resistance in the fluid. Inertia force to the viscous force in the fluid. Buoyancy force to the viscous force in the fluid. So you have to be very careful. It is some of the statements are confusing, irrelevant. So the option is B. Conductive resistance in the solid to the convective resistance in the fluid. The heat loss from a fin is 6 watts. The effectiveness and efficiency of the fin are 3 and 0.75 respectively. The heat loss in watt from the fin keeping the entire fin surface at the base temperature is dash. So look at the statement. We have to calculate heat loss in watts from the fin keeping the entire fin surface is at the base temperature. That is the Q maximum, maximum heat transfer. So given data, Q equal to 6 watts, eta equal to efficiency equal to 0.75, effectiveness equal to 3. So Q maximum equal to the heat loss from the fin keeping the entire fin surface at the base temperature. So from the definition of efficiency, we can calculate eta equal to actual heat transfer divided by maximum possible heat transfer. So maximum heat transfer equal to 6 divided by 0.75 equal to 8 watts. So the answer is 8 watts. So we stop here. So these are all the books I have published in the mechanical engineering subject, and I have a YouTube channel where I upload the video lectures on the subjects mentioned here, and the solution to the gate questions are also uploaded in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, use the video lectures for your better preparation and pass in the gate examination. So thank you for watching. You please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. So we'll meet again with another video lecture on the conduction heat transfer from the gate question papers.